So what about you, Marcel? What do you want? Let's talk about Irene. So... I guess diplomatic would be the best. Keep having fights with Irene won't improve our situation, Marshall. We have to keep going. Tell me, you know, motherfucker, did you get a cross on her or you're being a pain in the ass just for fun? I'm not sure. How would I respond to that kind of... Well, he is annoying, considering what kind of what he called me. But on the other hand, I probably should be taking the same advice as I gave her and not be all the way provoking. So maybe worried? I'm just worried that this continuous dispute could weaken the group. The group will be united for our own interest until we're all safe and sound. It's called survival instinct. Irrational. The group will keep its unity if the eternal hostilities won't become intolerable. If you keep acting like that, the situation explodes at any time. I know what I do. Don't annoy me, you know, motherfucker. Leave me alone. This conversation's getting boring. What do you want? Do tell about your past, though. Why did you come here in Zaharia? I'm just one of the many Idoran fighters who decided to set sail looking for a future in these lands. In my homeland, they talk about Zaharia as a gold mine for mercenaries, but reality is different from local rumors. I made it in spite of everything, as you can see, but it wasn't easy. I think this is not the right time to tell you all the amazing story of my life. Shouldn't we think about something else? It's like, let's say, a noose around our neck that keeps tightening. So, expedition. Ironic, ours was not one of the best expeditions, huh? I will never understand Soren's crazy idea to go looking for our lost temples in the desert. Not to mention that he wanted to venture in dangerous paths, totally ignoring the danger that the savages of the desert could represent. I don't think I know that much about the history and stuff. I'm not gonna be supporting, so neutral. Surely the archaeological study is important as they can be, aren't worth the death of many people. Exactly, and I don't really understand what's the point of studying some rocks from the past. And now we find ourselves in this shitty situation, all this just to see some old painting of 1,000 years ago. Well, we'll do what will be necessary to leave. I don't want to die in this desert. Neither do I. So get your weapons ready, cause we'll soon cook some nomads too. I'm just kidding, but it won't find anything to eat. I'm going to eat those ashes. Anyway, with this heat, they'll be already roasted when we'll meet them. They'll be ready for tonight's dinner. Oh, well, quit talking then. Then there's a few other people here. Navid nods at you and turns away. He doesn't look like a talkative guy. Fine. What about you? You seem very wounded, empathetic. How are you, Gip? Don't give up, man. Even if you think the situation bad, you'll get out of it alive. I'm a soldier. I've already seen wounds like this in the past, and only a few men managed to survive. Then, we're in the middle of a desert. I don't like how things are going. I don't like it at all. Gip makes a painful face and touches his wounded leg. I guess we should deceive him so that he might have more like a hope of surviving. You should stay calm, your conditions are not that bad. Karm is only sad for what happened, don't let his mood influence you. What you have is only a wound that will easily heal. Probably you're right. Fuck him. He has no a scratch and he complains more than everyone else. Karin's an asshole. Did there? No. assertive. Exactly, he's not the one who's wounded. He should only help you as best he can, not just complaining. At least he can do his job. I rarely work with doctors so skilled. Now excuse me, but the pain is driving me crazy. I can't even talk anymore. Well, alright, Gib. And please, don't give up. Okay? Okay, then there's Karim. Karim watches you and nods his head. Gib. Worried, how's Gib? It didn't seem like it was that great. Gib is seriously wounded and his conditions are getting worse and worse each moment that passes. I guess we could be propositive? What can we do to help him? Is there something you need? No, I managed to seal the abdomen and the leg wounds with what I had here, but without water and wood, he will die soon. He lost a lot of blood, and he needs a way to produce it. You can clearly see the depression in Karim's face. Realistic. We'll do everything we can, Karim. I don't know if this will be useful at the end, but we'll try anyway. Karim looks into the void. You don't even understand whether he listened to you or not. He's clearly distressed for what's happening to Gib. Suddenly he seems to be conscious again and starts talking to you. I'll go back to Gib unless you've got something else to ask me. Condition. I guess I could ask what's up because he was just flowing into a distance and all. Karim, are you sure you're doing good? I hardly recognize you. Where's your usual happiness? Did you really just ask me that? Look around you, man, and do it with the eyes of reason. We're done for. It's not that bad. And you should do the same, or realist, one or the other. Determined. No, Karim. We'll be done for only when we'll stop fighting back. I don't have the slightest intentions to stop fighting, and you should do the same. Isn't it just easier to wait for our deaths to come? Why fighting against the inevitable? Okay. So, our different options. I think intuition is the one we're gonna be going. Because we're human beings, our full existence is born to the appearance of problems and to how we manage to solve them. To give up doesn't just mean to die, but also to disown what we really are. Creatures were born to fight against adversities, and were able to grow up internally thanks to this eternal fight. Finally, the sight of Karim seems to light up, at least for a moment. You're right, you're definitely right, it's not the time to let things go. Job. Why you started the medical career? Yeah. I've been in close contact with the world of medicine since I was young, thanks to my father. He was a doctor and I assisted him many times. When I grew up, I studied in Ashandir at the Science Academy, one of the most important in the medicine field. After getting my diploma, I started practicing in the field while doing research with several other scientists, among which there were also some astronomers. Their experts are well known in all Zaharia. Be quiet or ask. I guess I could be interested. So, astronomers, but aren't they supposed to deal with stars and planets? Aren't they supposed to deal? Only some time ago. Now they've become a heterogeneous scientist and magical association. They kept their name only for prestige reasons. There's no much else to say about. After all, a short time ago I've been contacted to join this expedition. With hindsight, I'd have probably refused. Don't say it. You saved a lot of men during the trip, and now you'll also save Gib. If you weren't here for him, he'll have been already dead now. If only I had my medical instruments, my medicines, and my assistant. Assistant? You had an assistant? Yes, a young skilled mage specialized in healing arts. Contrary to what people think, healing magic makes no miracles, but surely it would have been useful to stabilize Gib's condition, to alleviate his pain and facilitate his wound's regeneration. Unfortunately, he died during the assault. Or at least I think he died. I haven't seen him. I was in the other part of the caravan when they attacked us. Let's say comforting. Muster up courage even for him to keep his memory alive in our thoughts so that his sacrifice won't be in vain. I'm sorry, but I won't want to talk about these things anymore. Is there anything else I can do for you? I'm going now. Good luck and please hurry up. Alright, so if we take supplies now, then... Yeah, here. So take, we need them, let's pick them up. Just us, food, water and some handy weapons, okay. Alright, the angle changed and he is running back. So what news do you have? I tried to get close without being noticed. There are three different groups of nomads. The two largest groups are in war between themselves. One has settled near the same temple Irene would like to visit. The other one, far bigger, is camped near a canyon. We don't stand a chance against them, at least in case of a battle. The Aussies instead is guarded only by a little family as we suspected. There is just a few of them and they are wounded. They are not a threat for us. What do they have in mind, these savages? If they were them, I'd camp inside the water. I'm dying of heat. They're used to living in the desert. Besides, the Aussies is surrounded by pretty high dunes. If they were not neutral, they're already being taken by surprise and killed. Perfect, they'll be willing to deal with us. Let's take food and water and let's get out of here. Why all this hurry? I thought they were friends of yours. I thought the wrong voice. An angry expression appears in Irene's face, but it's immediately held back. Yeah, she holds it back. Let it go. Gip needs water and food. He lost a lot of blood. He's not good at all. Okay, we'll immediately take off for the Oasis. Zora and the translator will come with me. Navid, you'll stay here to protect Gip. Yes, sir. I'm coming with you. I'm coming with you. I can't wait to see the fighting skills of the Zaharian girls. After having taunted Irene for the last time, he goes away, preventing her from responding. Classy. Asshole. Just deal with it for the moment and I'm being. Take your weapons and let's go. You have to hurry. Keep won't last for long. Right, let's go. Okay, let's go indeed. I do like the graphics and overall how the angle changes and all that. Though it does maybe feel a little bit weird how the group moves, but not sure how it would be then in the reality, but a lot of things would be changing anyways, so I'm not gonna be too, well, talking too much about that. I don't see exactly the water, but let's move into here. Here's the people anyways. Am I wrong or are we walking straight ahead towards them? Well, what did you expect? Zaharian raises his hands to make the nomads understand your peaceful intentions. I don't know how you Zaharians usually organize assaults. Shut up, they saw us. Go away, strangers! The soldier addresses the group with great hostility. Leave us alone! Well, I guess we could use the speed scrap. You don't have to fear us. We're not here to fight, but just to look for some food and water. We'll honor your presence and we won't raise the sword against you. A man dressed with different colored clothing addresses you. Stranger, you know our language, but your beautiful words don't fool us. Intuition. Just take a look at us. Just take a look at us. We're just a little group like you. We don't want to fight. Exactly like you. We're here hoping you'll let us take some supplies. Then we'll go away and won't come back. Why in the world should I trust you, strangers? You have been our enemies since the day I was born. Honorable. Pragmatic. You could trust us because, as you can see, we came here to talk. And you could also think about the fact that if the situation gets bad, you could all die without a reason. You come here to threaten my family? Your nature is evil and corrupt. What will keep you from attacking us as soon as we let our guard down? Straightforward or honorable? Honor exists even between us Zaharians. If I promise you that nobody intends to attack you, you can be sure nothing bad will happen. The head of the family waits until you're finished to talk, then he turns to one of his relatives and says something. What's happening? Are they quarreling? Let's stay neutral, so it seems. We'll let you take the water, but I don't want you to see you anymore. We'll leave as soon. Well, I guess we're satisfied. I'm glad reason won. We'll leave as soon as possible. Don't see the water though, but well, supplies we took was from this kind of a thing, so I guess from this that's water. Food. I guess we can only take water. You can take some water now. Take the water. You can leave the area now. I would want some food as well. What? What did it say? Food. You can't take the food without starting a fight here. So, Zoran, where do you want to go? Let's go back to camp. At least we got the water. It's something. Let's go back to our camp. Alright, let's go. Let's get going. Back to the camp. We only have the water though, so if we were more diplomatic, I'm sure it could be different. But I'm gonna be ending this here for now and see if it all recorded well and fine and continue from here after this. So I hope you enjoyed thus far and thanks for watching.